students, today we are going to start a topic, circles, and it is one of the very important topic in coordinate geometry. Either you take for board exams or for any competitive examination, definitely questions will be coming from this topic, circles. And not only in point of that examinations, almost all concepts, notations, everything which are very similar to other topics which we will cover in the next classes, which are parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. Therefore, every one of you, my request is concentrate seriously on this topic and learn all the concepts thoroughly. Definitely, I am sure that the other topics will be easier for you, will become definitely easy for you. And while watching this video, my request is, please every one of you maintain your notes and write whatever the important points you feel, then it will be very easy for you to revise these topics, I mean at a point of time afterwards. So maintain your notes and listen carefully and learn all the concepts thoroughly. And in this lecture, today's lecture, we are going to cover very basic concepts. What is definition of a circle and what is the equation of circle and some very basic properties of that circle only we are going to see. So, shall we start this topic? Yes. What is a circle? Definition of circle. Circle is locus of a moving point which is at a constant distance from a fixed point. What is the meaning of this one? Let us see. Let us take this as a fixed point and I will name it as C. Now, locus of a moving point which is at a constant distance from this fixed point. Let me take some point here, it is P, which is the moving point. This distance is equal to some R I will take, and locus of this moving point, I mean anywhere if you take this point P, this distance is fixed. This is equal to R, this is equal to R, this is equal to R, and so on. Now, locus of this moving point P is called a circle, and this fixed point is called center of the circle, and this fixed distance is called radius of the circle. So, once again, let us see the definition. It is locus of a moving point P, which is at a constant distance from this fixed point, is called a circle. And this fixed point is called center of the circle, and this fixed distance or constant distance is called radius of the circle. Or we can say circle is collection of all those points in the plane which are at a constant distance from a fixed point. Or even we can say in other way, the path traced by a point, the path traced by a point by satisfying a given condition, that condition is nothing but at a fixed distance or constant distance from this fixed point, that is called a circle. That fixed point is called center and fixed distance is nothing but radius. And now, let us see how to find equation of this circle. Let us take this fixed point C as alpha comma beta, and this fixed distance, we call it as a radius, is equal to R. See, while giving definition of that circle, I used the term locus. Now, we are trying to find equation of that locus. To find equation of that locus, every one of you already you know that we must choose a point in that locus and we have to establish a mathematical relation for that condition, and then if I simplify I will get that equation to that locus. I will take this P moving point x1 comma y1. It is a point on that locus. Therefore, I will take let P x1 comma y1 be any point in the locus. Now, what is the relation I can write for C, P and R? Distance from this point to this moving point is equal to R. Therefore, here CP is equal to R. This CP is a distance between these two points C and P, that is root over x1 minus alpha whole square plus y1 minus beta whole square equal to R. On squaring this equation, we will get x1 minus alpha whole square plus y1 minus beta whole square equal to R square. Therefore, locus means replace x1 comma y1 with general point x comma y. I will write it as therefore locus of P x1 comma y1 is x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square is equal to R square. It is the equation of the circle with center at alpha comma beta and radius of the circle is equal to R. Therefore, center alpha comma beta and radius is equal to R means equation of circle is x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to R square. I will write again, when center is alpha comma beta and radius of the circle is equal to R, then equation of circle is x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square is equal to R square. Now, when center of this circle is 0 comma 0, then equation of this circle is x square plus y square equal to R square, and this equation is called standard equation of the circle. It is called standard equation. Circle. And when radius is equal to 1 for any circle, then that circle is called unit circle. And if radius equal to 0, then the circle equation will become x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to 0. Observe what does this represents. Square of a number plus square of a number equal to 0 means it must be equal to 0, it must be equal to 0. That is only the solution for that equation, that is alpha comma beta. Therefore, it is called a point circle. That is this equation represents only one point, that is nothing but alpha comma beta. That point is the center and radius equal to 0. Therefore, x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to 0 represents a point circle. That point is nothing but alpha comma beta only. Now, you see here, suppose if I take this is equation of the circle with center at alpha comma beta and radius equal to r, where r greater than 0. And if I take a point circle, that is this one. Whenever r greater than 0, how many number of points will lie on the circle? Infinitely many points will lie on the circle whenever r greater than 0. And if I take a point circle, how many points will lie on that circle? Only one circle, one point will lie on that circle. And whenever this r less than 0, then it represents imaginary circle. When r greater than 0 means infinitely many points lying on the circle. When r equal to 0 means there is only one point on that circle, that is nothing but that center only, alpha comma beta. And when r less than 0, it represents imaginary circle. There is no point which satisfies that equation. When center of the circle is alpha comma beta and radius of the circle is given r, then equation of circle in center and radius form x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. Now let us see one or two examples. When center of the circle is 1 comma 2 and radius of the circle is equal to 2, if I want equation of circle, observe here, center alpha comma beta is equal to 1 comma 2 and radius r is equal to 2, therefore equation of circle I can write it as x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 2 square. Second example, when center is equal to 0 comma minus 3 and radius is equal to 3 units, if I take, I want equation of circle. Now here alpha comma beta equal to 0 comma minus 3 and r is equal to 3, therefore in this case equation of circle will become x minus 0 whole square plus y minus of minus 3 whole square is equal to 3 square, or x square plus y plus 3 whole square is equal to 9 will be the equation of this circle. X minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. We have seen it is the equation of circle with center at alpha comma beta and radius r. And if I expand this equation, x square plus y square minus 2 alpha x minus 2 beta y plus alpha square plus beta square minus r square is equal to 0. So, you observe, when you expand it, you are getting a second degree equation, and in that second degree equation, you can observe coefficient of x square and y square are equal, and there is no xy term in this. Of course, coefficient of x may be there, coefficient of y may be there, and complete this alpha, beta and r are constants, therefore alpha square plus beta square minus r square is a constant. Now, let us try to write a general equation of this circle. See here, what is the general equation of the circle? If g square plus f square minus c greater than or equal to 0, then x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a circle with center c minus g comma minus f and radius root over g square plus f square minus c. And this equation is called general equation of the circle. Observe this. If g square plus f square minus c greater than or equal to 0, then this second degree equation x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a circle whose center is at minus g comma minus f and a radius equal to root of g square plus f square minus c. Actually, it is a result. Let us see this one. I will take this equation x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. For this, what I will do? X square plus 2gx plus g square plus y square plus 2fy plus f square is equal to g square plus f square minus c. What I have done here, you see, g square I have added on both sides, f square I have added on both sides, and this c I have taken that side. Therefore, other terms are this one, x square plus 2gx plus g square I have written, and y square plus 2fy I have written here, and these two terms I wrote here it is. I have added this g square to write it as a perfect square and f square to write this as perfect square. Therefore, now this equation can be written as x plus g whole square plus y plus f whole square is equal to g square plus f square minus c, or that implies x minus of minus g whole square plus y minus of minus f whole square is equal to square root of g square plus f square minus c whole square. Yes. Now observe this. Clearly it is of the form x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. Whenever an equation of this form x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square means, it represents a circle with center at alpha comma beta and radius is equal to r. Therefore, because this exactly in this form of the form x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square is equal to r square. Therefore, center is nothing but alpha comma beta and radius equal to this part. Hence, we can write center of this circle is minus g comma minus f and radius is equal to root over g square plus f square minus c. Because it is under square root, it is defined only when it is greater than or equal to 0, and that's why if g square plus f square minus c greater than or equal to 0, then this equation represents a circle whose center is at minus g comma minus f and radius is nothing but root of g square plus f square minus c. And it is greater than 0 means it represents a circle with radius, I mean positive, and if it is equal to 0 means again we can say it represents a point circle with that point at minus g comma minus f. Therefore, now you remember general equation of circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Center of that circle at minus g comma minus f and radius of that circle is root of g square plus f square minus c. Why many times I am telling you is almost throughout the chapter, whenever we require equation of a circle, we will assume that circle as this one, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, always. And you can observe, whenever circle is in this form, center is nothing but half of the coefficient of x, half of the coefficient of y. What is coefficient of x here? 2g. What is coefficient of y here? 2f. Half of the coefficient means g, half of the coefficient of y means f, with opposite signs. For g comma f, opposite signs are minus g comma minus f, that will be the center. Therefore, observe circle equation and see that coefficient of x square and y square are equal to 1 or not. If they are equal to 1, directly you take half of the coefficient of x comma half of the coefficient of y with opposite signs. If coefficient of x square and y square not equal to 1, then make them as 1 by dividing with that quantity, and then you can take center as half of the coefficient of x and half of the coefficient of y with opposite signs. And whereas radius of that circle is, when these coefficients are equal to 1, square of this plus square of this minus constant term will become radius of that circle. So, please understand this one, general equation of this circle, and center is minus g comma minus f and radius equal to root of g square plus f square minus c. Let us see one or two examples on this. Suppose equation is x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 1 equal to 0. We need center and radius of the circle. Yes, it is general equation form only, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. We can observe coefficient of x square and y square equal to 1. Therefore, center is half of the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x minus 4. Half means minus 2. That is, with opposite sign means minus of minus 4 by 2 we can take. And here, minus of minus 6 by 2 we can take. It is equal to 2 comma 3. And now, radius of this circle is equal to square of this 2 square plus 3 square minus constant means minus 1. It is equal to root of 4 plus 9 plus 1 is root 14 is the radius of this circle. One more example. Suppose equation is x square plus y square plus x minus 7y minus 2 equal to 0, then find center and radius. Yes, here also coefficient of x square and y square both are equal and equal to 1, no problem here. You need not divide with anyone, anything. So, because it is in the standard form, general equation form, center is minus g comma minus f. I mean coefficient of x 1, half means 1 by 2, minus of 1 by 2, comma minus of minus 7 by 2 will be the center, that is equal to minus 1 by 2 comma 7 by 2 is the center of the circle. And now coming to radius, radius of this circle is equal to square root of g square plus f square, minus c means minus of minus 2. It is equal to square root of 1 by 4 plus 49 by 4 plus 2. 49 plus 1, 50, 50 plus 8, it is root 58 by 4 will be the radius of this circle. Hope you understood how to find center and radius of the circle when it is of the form x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Let us see one more example. Find center and radius of the circle 3x square plus 3y square minus 6x plus 5y minus 9 equal to 0. Yes. Difference between this problem and previous examples, what we have done, their coefficient of x square and y square are equal to 1. Therefore, no need of dividing that coefficient of x square, y square with anything there. Whereas here, coefficient of x square and y square are equal, of course, that is equal to 3. To find center and radius, first divide that equation with 3. Make coefficient of x square and y square equal to 1 always. Don't forget this one. Always do remember. To find center and radius, see that coefficient of x square and y square are equal to 1 or not. Now, divide it with 3, this equation will become x square plus y square minus 2x plus 5 by 3 into y minus 3 equal to 0. I have divided with 3. Now, it is the general form. Therefore, center of this circle will become minus of minus 2 by 2 comma minus of half of the coefficient means it will become 5 by 6. It is equal to 1 comma minus 5 by 6 will be the center. And now coming to radius, it is square root of g square 1 square plus f square 25 by 36 minus c means plus 3 it will become, or it is equal to square root of 4 plus 25 by 36 will be the radius of this circle. Hope you understood how to find center and radius of the circle when it is of the form x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Do practice more number of problems on this concept, when equation of this circle is given, how to find center and radius, so that you will get familiarity with, this equation and how to find center and radius of the circle. Let us move to the next concept. Concept means we have observed equation of circle is a second degree equation in terms of x and y. Either you take center and radius form or general form. What is general equation of circle already we have seen?
x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0.
It is a 2-degree equation. In straight lines and a pair of straight lines, we have come across with a second degree non-homogeneous equation. That is, ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Now, let us see, that is a second degree equation. What are the conditions to be imposed on those parameters to represent that as a circle? What is a second degree non-homogeneous equation? Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Observe this. Circle is a second degree equation in terms of x and y. We will cover other topics of conic sections, parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. All those are the second degree equations in terms of x and y. Therefore, it is very important to, take this second degree non-homogeneous equation, and we have to see what are the conditions on these parameters so that when it represents a circle and when it represents a parabola, when it represents an ellipse and when it represents a hyperbola, all those we will cover in those topics. Now, because we are doing circles, what are the conditions on these parameters when it represents a circle, we will see. Now, you observe, it is a general equation of a circle. It is a circle means coefficient of x square and y square must be always equal. Therefore, first point is coefficient of x square should be equal to coefficient of y square. That is a equal to b, because coefficient of x square is a and coefficient of y square equal to b. Therefore, a must be equal to b. That is the first point, first condition. And second condition, you see, it is a general equation. X square is there, y square is there, x is there, y is there, constant is there. X and y coefficients may be 0 or constant may be 0, that is immaterial here. But you can easily observe that there is no xy term here. Xy term will not come in equation of circle. Therefore, in this xy coefficient is there, to represent this equation as a circle means xy term should not be there, hence coefficient of xy must be equal to 0. What is coefficient of xy here? 2h is equal to 0, that implies h is equal to 0. So, first condition, this coefficient of x square and y square must be equal, and second condition, this h value must be equal to 0. And now, to represent a real circle, we know radius of the circle should be greater than or equal to 0. Let us see what is the radius when these two conditions hold. Now, because coefficient of x square and y square are equal, let us take b is equal to a. This equation will become now ax square plus ay square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Now, here coefficient of x square and y square both are equal and equal to a. To find center and radius, we must make coefficient of x square and y square equal to 1. So, divide with a. This equation will become x square plus y square plus 2g by a into x plus 2f by a into y plus c by a equal to 0. Clearly, it is of that form. What is the center of this circle, you see? Center is half of the coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x here? 2g by a. Half of the coefficient means g by a. And half of the coefficient of y means f by a with opposite signs, that is minus g by a comma minus f by a will be the center. And what will be the radius of this circle? It is equal to square of this plus square of this minus constant term, that is g square by a square plus f square by a square minus c by a, which is equal to root of g square plus f square minus ac by a square. Because it is under square root, it is defined only when it is positive, greater than or equal to 0. Denominator a square, there is no problem with that. Therefore, numerator is there, that is g square plus f square minus ac must be greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, whenever these three conditions hold, then this equation always represents a real circle. So, what are the conditions on these parameters so as to represent this equation a circle? Coefficient of x square equal to y square means a equal to b, and there should not be any xy term means coefficient of xy 0, that is h equal to 0, and radius of this one to represent a real circle means that should be greater than or equal to 0, that will come it as g square plus f square minus ac greater than or equal to 0. These are the conditions on the parameters. Now, hope you understood this one. Let us see one problem on this concept. Lambda minus 3 into x square plus mu minus 1 into xy plus mu minus 3 into y square plus 2x plus y minus 1 equal to 0 represents a circle. What are the values of lambda and mu? It is a second degree equation. In fact, it is of the form second degree non-homogeneous equation. It represents a circle means, just now we have seen coefficient of x square must be equal to y square, first condition. What is coefficient of x square here? First condition, coefficient of x square equal to coefficient of y square. Coefficient of x square lambda minus 3. Coefficient of y square is mu minus 3. That is, lambda is equal to mu. And second condition is coefficient of xy is equal to 0, that is mu minus 1 is the coefficient of xy, it should be equal to 0, that is mu equal to 1. Therefore, what are the lambda and mu values now? Lambda is equal to mu is equal to 1, hence this equation will become lambda equal to mu equal to 1 means minus 2x square. Any of mu equal to 1 means 0, minus 2y square plus 2x plus y minus 1 equal to 0. And if I multiply with minus sign, it will become 2x square plus 2y square minus 2x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. And if I divide it with 2, or this is the equation of circle, or I can write it as x square plus y square minus x minus 1 by 2 into y plus 1 by 2 equal to 0 is the equation of that circle. I mean, values of lambda and mu are lambda equal to mu equal to 1. For these values, circle equation if you want, that will become x square plus y square minus x minus 1 by 2 into y plus 1 by 2 equal to 0. So, till now what are the concepts we have covered? Just what is the definition of a circle and how to find equation of circle when center and radius are given, and general equation of a circle, and when if you take second degree non-homogeneous equation, what are the conditions on that parameters when it represents a circle we have seen. Now, let us move to other concept. I mean, how to find equation of a circle when ends of diameter are given? Finding equation of circle when
ends of diameter are given.
1 second here, everyone.
If I take this is a circle.
If you take any two points on the circle, suppose let it be A and let it be B, and if I join this one. Now this line AB is called secant line. And the line segment AB is called chord of the circle. It is the chord of the circle. And of course, length AB is called length of the chord. The biggest chord among all those chords of a circle is nothing but diameter of the circle. Diameter or biggest chord means it is always passing through the center of the circle. It is the biggest chord, or we call it as a diameter. Now, ends of diameter are given. Let me take this is one of the diameter. Let it be A and B. Let us take capital A x1 comma y1 and capital B x2 comma y2 as ends of diameter. These are the coordinates. Now our, job is to find equation of the circle when these two points are given. This A x1 comma y1 and B x2 comma y2. Let us see one way of finding equation of circle when ends of diameter are given. What is the method one to find equation of this circle is? When it is a diameter, you know that it is a semicircle and it is a semicircle. And if I choose any point P whose coordinates are x, y, now this angle APB will become angle in a semicircle, and you know that angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees. Angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees means that lines PA and PB are perpendicular. A coordinates given, B coordinates given, we have taken PX, Y is a point. Therefore, we can find the slope of this line AP and slope of this line BP, and because they are perpendicular, product of their slopes equal to minus 1. You learn this concept in straight lines, we will apply that one here. And we know since angle APB is angle in a semicircle, angle APB is equal to 90 degrees, that is pi by 2. That implies we can write AP is perpendicular to BP, or PA is perpendicular to PB. Let us find slope of PA. It is y minus y1 by x minus x1. And slope of PB, that is y minus y2 by x minus x2. Since these two are perpendicular, therefore slope of PA into slope of PB is equal to minus 1. What is slope of PA here? Y minus y1 by x minus x1 into y minus y2 by x minus x2 is equal to minus 1. If I cross multiply this equation and if I bring that term also this side, this equation will become x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to 0. Therefore, it is the equation of circle when ends of diameter are x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now, observe, when ends of diameter are given, without using this formula also, you can find equation of the circle. Always remember, to find equation of circle, what are the requirements?
This is a basic point every one of you must, understand.
See, in straight lines we have seen, suppose we need equation of a line. What are the requirements to find equation of a circle, straight line? We need one point and slope of that line. Slope of that line means, if I know angle made by that line with positive x-axis is theta, and if any point capital A x1 comma y1 is given, now I can write equation of this line. This information to find equation of line. That line equation I will write y minus y1. When theta is the inclination, tan theta is the slope into x minus x1. So, here also to find equation of circle, requirements, basic point is we need center and radius of the circle. Remember always, to find equation of circle means we are searching for center and radius. If we know center and radius, we can write equation of the circle. Here you observe, that is what method 2 I can see. Ends of diameter are given. Ends of diameter are given means length of AB is equal to 2 times of radius. Therefore, radius is equal to AB by 2. We know radius. And because these two are the ends of diameter, center is midpoint of AB only. Therefore, we can find center of the circle also. Therefore, center is equal to midpoint of AB. That is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Therefore, now we know center and radius. Hence, we can write equation of the circle. Therefore, equation of circle is x minus of x1 plus x2 by 2 whole square plus y minus of y1 plus y2 by 2 whole square is equal to this AB by 2 whole square, I can write. Clearly, it is of the form x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. On simplification and rearranging the terms exactly, we will get this form only. So, either you can use this formula directly, that is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0, or find a midpoint and distance AB, which is 2R, and from that R equal to AB by 2, then also you can write equation of the circle. 1 minute, again you observe this diagram. Even you can use one more property to find equation of circle here. What is that you concentrate here? APB is a right angle triangle. Because triangle APB is right angled, I can use Pythagoras theorem. PA square plus PB square is equal to AB square. PA square plus PB square equal to AB square. Even if I solve this one, I am going to get equation of circle only. Therefore, even you can use this property also to find equation of that circle. Of course, at that moment, whichever it comes to your mind and whichever the method you feel easy, that you can apply to find equation of the circle. See, we have seen equation of circle with AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 as ends of diameter is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. It is x1, y1 and these are x2, y2. If I write this equation, just observe this, plus y minus y2 into y minus y1 equal to 0. Now, you see these two equations, This is the equation of circle when AX1Y1 and BX2Y2 as ends of diameter. I have just interchanged these two. Now, can I write here X1Y2 and X2Y1 as ends of diameter? Yes, exactly, it looks like that only. When x1 y1 and x2 y2 as ends of diameter, x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. I have written y minus y2 y minus y1, therefore I can say if I take these as ends of diameter, x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y2 into y minus y1 equal to 0. Can I say here x1 y2 and x2 y1 as ends of diameter? Yes. x1, y2 and x2, y1 are also ends of diameter, but of course it is not the diameter same as this one, it is one of the other diameters. You observe clearly whether these points lie on this circle or not. x1, y2, if I substitute, it will become 0, y2 means it will become 0, therefore this point lies on this. And x2, y1, if I are trying to substitute, yes, x2 minus x2, it will become 0, y1 minus y1, it will become 0, therefore both the points lie on the circle. And because this equation represents equation of circle when ends of diameter are these, yes, these are the ends of diameter only. How exactly these on the diagram we will see. Suppose capital A x1 y1, and let it be the center, capital B x2 y2, these are the ends of diameter we have taken initially. Now what I will do, passing through A x1 y1, one horizontal line I will take and one vertical line I will take. Now, equation of this vertical line, x equal to x1, you know, if these are the coordinate axis, it is the y axis and it is the x axis. It is the vertical line that is parallel to y axis passing through x1, y1 is x equal to x1. And it is the horizontal line parallel to y axis and passing through x1, y1, we can write it as y equal to y1. And similarly, I will write one horizontal line, I will draw it, and one vertical line passing through that other. Because it is the vertical line passing through x2, y2, it is x equal to x2, and because it is the horizontal line passing through this, y equal to y2. Now, what are the coordinates of this point, you see, because it is on this vertical line x coordinate is x1, on this horizontal line y equal to y2, coordinate of this point are x1, y2. And what are the coordinates of this point, you see, because this point on this vertical line x equal to x2, and this horizontal line y equal to y1, hence coordinates of this point are x2, y1. And observe, this is the horizontal line and it is a vertical line, this angle is 90, and this angle is 90, and here it is 90, here it is 90, therefore it is a rectangle. Rectangle and it is one diagonal which is the diameter of the circle, therefore hence this is another diagonal that is a diameter of the circle. If I name it as a P and it is a Q, yes, I can say P, Q are also ends of diameter which are nothing but one point is x1, y2 and other point is x2, y1. Hope you understood this one. Whenever x1, y1 and x2, y2 are ends of diameter means, even I can say x1, y2 and x2, y1 are also ends of diameter. Of course, it is other diameter other than this diameter, one of the other diameters of the circle. Even we can write this one also. Again, we will look at this equation only. X minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. This point what I am going to discuss is very important for any entrance exams. You can observe that there are two terms, I mean total. I will treat this as one term and this as another term. And this term is a quadratic in terms of x and this term is a quadratic in terms of y. So, sum of those two quadratic equations we can observe. If I equate them to 0, x minus x1 into x minus x2 equal to 0 and y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to 0. I can say this equation is sum of these two quadratic equations equal to 0. What is the meaning of this one? X minus x1 into x minus x2 equal to 0 means it is a quadratic equation whose roots are x1 comma x2. And it is a quadratic equation in terms of y whose roots are y1 comma y2. Here it is x1 comma x2 and here it is y1 comma y2. This quadratic equation roots x1 and x2 and here it is y1 and y2. Therefore, I can say here, because our ends of diameter are x1 y1 and x2 y2, once again I will write x1 comma y1 and b x2 comma y2. Here we know x1 comma y x2, these are the x coordinates of a and b, which we call them as abscissa of A and B. Those are the roots of this equation. And y1 comma y2 are the ordinates of these points A comma B, which are the roots of this equation. And quadratic equation whose roots are abscissa of A and B are x minus x1 into x minus x2 equal to 0. And quadratic equation whose ordinates are y1 comma y2 in terms of variable y is y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Therefore, sum of these two quadratic equations will be the equation of this circle. Hope you understood. And exactly what type of questions they will ask on this concept, let us see one question. Suppose they have given capital A x1 comma y1 and capital B x2 comma y2. Also given, abscissa of these points, that is x1 comma x2, are the roots of the quadratic equation x square plus ax plus b equal to 0 and ordinates of this equation, that is y1 comma y2, are the roots of the quadratic equation y square plus by, b already we have used, y square plus dy plus e equal to 0. Now, because x1 comma x2 are the roots of this equation, now I want equation of, they are asking equation of circle with A comma B as ends of diameter. This is the question. Please observe this. Given A x1 comma y1 and B x2 comma y2. What they have given? Abscissa of A comma B, that is x1 comma x2 are the roots of this equation.
ordinates of those points, that is y1 comma y2 are the roots of this equation given, then they are asking us to find equation of circle with x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2 as ends of diameter in terms of a, b, d, e. Now, how to find it? We know already equation of circle when a and b as ends of diameter is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Let it be 1. And again one point here, because x1 comma x2 are the roots of that equation, x square plus ax plus b can be written as x minus x1 into x minus x2. Since coefficient of x square equal to 1, straight away I can write this. You have clear idea about this one. It is a quadratic. Coefficient of x square is 1. Roots are x1 comma x2, means we can write x square plus ax plus b is equal to x minus x1 into x minus x2. I think no doubt in this. Next. Similarly, because y1 comma y2 are the roots of this equation where leading coefficient is 1, hence this one again can be written as y square plus dy plus e can be written as y minus y1 into y minus y2. Therefore, x minus x1 into x minus x2 value this, which I can substitute here. Y minus y1 into y minus y2 value is this, which I can substitute here, and which represents a circle equation. Therefore, equation of the circle is x square plus ax plus b plus y square plus dy plus e equal to 0, or rewriting this, x square plus y square plus ax plus dy plus b plus e equal to 0. Observe what I have done. Just addition of these equations will be the final equation, will be the final equation. But only one thing, one care you must take, that coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square here, both must be same. Need not be one, but both must be equal. Equal. Here, because obviously here it is 1, here it is 1, I have added here. Suppose if it is a, then either you multiply this one with a or divide this one with a and make their coefficients of leading terms are equal, and then on adding these two equations you will get the required equation of the circle. This is one of the very, very important concept, and definitely, you know, based on that concept, so they are asking problems in many exams, competitive exams, definitely coefficients will come on that concept. Let us see one problem on this. Suppose capital A 1 comma 3 and capital B minus 3 comma minus 1. Minus 3 comma minus 1. We need equation of circle with these two points as ends of diameter. A 1 comma 3 and B minus 3 comma minus 1 as ends of diameter, I want equation of the circle. Method 1 is by using formula. What is that formula? When it is x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2, equation of that circle is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to 0. Here it is x1, y1 and second point is x2, comma y2. Therefore, x minus 1 into x plus 3 plus y minus 1 into y minus y2 plus 1 is equal to 0. X1, y1, 1 comma 3, x2, y2 minus 3 comma minus 1
Therefore, if I substitute those points as it is, this is the equation. Or on simplifying this, x square plus 2x minus 3 plus y square minus 2y minus 2 minus 3 is equal to 0. Or that implies x square plus y square plus 2x minus 2y minus 6 equal to 0. This one directly by using the formula. Even we can use other method here, already we have discussed while deriving that equation. Here it is capital A and it is capital B. Capital A given 1 comma 3 and capital B given minus 3 comma minus 1. As already I told you that to find equation of circle, we need center and radius. Therefore, center is nothing but midpoint of AB. Midpoint of AB means here it is 1 minus 3 by 2 comma 3 minus 1 by 2, which is equal to minus 1 comma 1. Minus 1 comma 1 is the center of the circle. And now radius. For radius means first we will find AB length is equal to 1 plus 3 whole square plus 3 plus 1 whole square. It is equal to root of 16 plus 16 is equal to root 32. It is equal to 2 root r, 4 root 2 will be the value. Now, what is the radius here? Radius is equal to half of this diameter only. It is equal to 2 root 2 will be the value. Now, I know center and radius. Therefore, equation of circle in center and radius form, equation of circle is x minus alpha means x plus 1 whole square plus y minus 1 whole square is equal to 2 root 2 whole square on expansion x square plus y square plus 2x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 8, or x square plus y square plus 2x minus 2y minus 6 equal to 0 will be the equation of the circle. Therefore, you observe either you can use this formula directly to find equation when ends of diameter are given, or simply you find midpoint which is the center of the circle and AB which is the diameter. Half of that if you take radius you can find, center you know, radius you know. Now, equation of circle you can write it as center radius form and simplify to find equation of that circle. So, dear students, in today's lecture, very basic points we have covered. Let us see what are the concepts we have covered till now. We have seen definition of circle, and second one, equation of circle when center is given alpha comma beta and radius is equal to given r. In this equation is x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. And when center is at 0 comma 0, what will be the equation? And when radius equal to 1, we know that that equation is called unit circle. And when radius equal to 0, that is called point circle. All those points we have seen. And next, standard general equation of a circle we have seen. General equation of a circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, and center of this circle is minus g comma minus f, and radius of this circle is equal to root over g square plus f square minus c. And fourth point, we have taken a second degree non-homogeneous equation. Like it is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. And we have seen conditions on these parameters when this equation represents a circle. And we have seen what are the conditions here. A equal to b, second point we have seen, h equal to 0, and third point we have seen g square plus f square minus ac greater than or equal to 0. And next, fifth point we have seen, how to find equation of circle when ends of diameter are given. If capital A x1 comma y1 and capital B x2 comma y2 are ends of diameter, then equation is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Yes, these are the points we have covered. Yes, every one of you see, when center alpha comma beta and radius r, equation of circle is x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. And when center is 0 comma 0, then equation of circle is x square plus y square equal to r square. And when r equal to 0, then that circle is called point circle. And general equation of circle we have seen, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. For this, center minus g comma minus f and radius root over g square plus f square minus c. Always here g square plus f square minus c should be greater than or equal to 0, so that it will represent a real circle. And fourth one, we have taken second degree non-homogeneous equation, and conditions on these parameters a, h, b, g, f, c, so that it represents a circle. Coefficient of x square and y square equal, coefficient of x, y equal to 0, and this g square plus f square minus ac, which will come in the, numerator of that radius greater than or equal to 0. And last final point we have seen in today's class, when a x1 y1 and b x2 y2 are ends of diameter, then equation of that circle is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. Of course, these are very basic points, but everyone must learn thoroughly all these points. Then in coming classes, all other, concepts will become easier for us. And hope you understood all the points which we have covered today, which are all very basic points, and we will cover next other concepts in the coming classes.